Hi, I'm in Delhi's Hoskars Village, which is hardly a village, as you can see. It's a place loaded with restaurants. I'm here to meet the owner of Amor, Navneet. She's waiting upstairs. Let's go up and check out what the food is like. Hi, I'm in Hoskars Village, Amor restaurant, one of the oldest restaurants here. And I have with me the gorgeous owner, Navneet, who will tell me what it's like. Hi Navneet, what it's like to run a restaurant in a place that was primarily known for its boutiques earlier.
Absolutely.
You're one of the oldest guys here,
yeah.
And you've been sustaining your business for 5-6 years.
Yeah.
Most people come here and close shop in 6 months.
Yeah.
How do you keep it going? Is it the food, is it the ambience?
I think you have to constantly evolve your menus. You have to always be concentrating on the quality.
Yeah.
The moment you let go of such things, then it's your downfall.
You also told me that you've trained a lot, you've picked up a lot of stuff in Italy because you were there 4 years.
Absolutely.
So she just spoke about the tiramisu, which I believe has real mascarpone cheese.
Yes.
Which is a rarity in Delhi.
Absolutely, yes. We're the only restaurant in all of Delhi, in fact, to use real mascarpone. And I can proudly say that it is one of the best tiramisus, as close as it gets to Italian tiramisu.
I also like the flooring and the way you've done the walls, and there are those boards as chairs over there.
Yes.
I mean, obviously a lot of attention to detail. Is this all your own doing, or have you hired an interiors person to do this for you?
We did have one initially, but then because our ideas do not gel together so well, because we're very strong-minded about what we want.
Yeah,
so
I can see
we
that.
Have, yes, we have hand-picked A to Z everything in this restaurant, starting from the styles to the flooring to the fabric. We've gone down to Jaipur and we've gone down to the most absurd antique shops to
pick
up us.
I also see this is a great party place. I think in winter, do you do any buffets and stuff in winter? Do you have some sundowning parties and things?
Yes,
we have a DJ playing in this place.
Absolutely, we have a Sunday brunch which is extremely popular, and it's an amazing feel to Delhi. And then after the Sunday brunch, it moves on to a sunset session. A DJ sunset.
So what are you going to be serving us today, which is so special and, you know, a part of this restaurant which you would like to showcase? I know there's a fabulous starter and there's a quail, I know that.
Yeah. One of the sheer favorites with all the customers is a non-vegetarian mezze platter. I think the moment it comes to the table, it just adds a lot of fun factor, there's a lot to discuss about it.
Great. Yeah.
I think you'll see it when it comes.
Yeah. And the quail? That's what I'm here for, the quail.
Yes, we have a pancetta wrapped quail.
Wow.
And for the vegetarians, we have a rice.
That's fine.
I don't want to disclose too much, you have to look at it.
Okay. So I've ordered what basically looks really nice to me now. I've got this non-veg mess platter. It's got some kebabs and it's got some prawns, some pita bread, loads of hummus. I've got a rosti here which looks really nice to me. It's potato basically, it's a nice veggie option. And what I came here for, the quail. It's got egg whites, it's got mushrooms, and I'm going to dig into this. Meal for two, 2,000 bucks. This is a decent pricing point for this kind of restaurant. It's really fine dining, really upmarket. And for more such food updates, subscribe to our YouTube channel, Red FM, Bajate Raho. And now guys, I would recommend you guys leave and just let me eat in peace. This looks really nice. 93.5